Welcome to our Haydn Quartet Marathon. We're gonna have two concerts today, and you'll be hearing the six Prussian quartets by Joseph Haydn in this concert and another one at 1:30. And in between, you're all welcome to a reception with Viennese inspired treats across the hallway. So we've been working on these quartets for several weeks now, and during the process, we unearthed a bit of a background story about Haydn's life and how these quartets came about. So we're gonna be sharing that with you in between each of the group's performances. So we're number one, opus 50 number one. We're gonna be playing the first quartet in this series. When Haydn wrote this piece, he was almost 55 years old, and it was the year 1787. And he was working for the noble Esterhazy family in Austria at the time, at their palace. And this was a great job for Haydn because even though it was isolated, it was like about 40 miles away from Vienna, he was the Kapellmeister there, or the music director, which means that he had lots of orchestra musicians and opera singers at his command. And his boss was the head of the house, Nicholas Esterhazy, who was a music lover and made all this possible for Haydn. So it was here at the Esterhazy Palace that he really developed a different kind of style for the string quartet repertoire. Before Haydn, it was basically violin solo and accompaniment, but Haydn kind of developed it into more equal parts for everybody. So it was more like conversation between four intelligent people. By the time he wrote, so this is why Haydn is called the father of the string quartet. By the time he wrote these quartets, he had already been working at the palace for like 25 years. So he was really familiar with the musicians there and like his job, which was to entertain the prince whenever the prince wanted music to be around. So we can imagine that many of his quartets were premiered perhaps in the palace in one of their many beautiful rooms, kind of like our very own field concert hall, except maybe a little grander.
Realize that at the same time Haydn was writing these quartets, George Washington was probably right here in Philadelphia at Independence Hall and discussing the Constitution with the Federal Convention, and the first three states were formed.
And back in Europe with Haydn, these six quartets were dedicated to the King of Prussia at that time, Frederick William II. He was a great devoted to the arts, so under his reign, architecture, dance, theater, and music all thrived, and he loved music so much, and he was also an amateur cellist. He wasn't a particularly great king in terms of political affairs, but his people really loved him, because at that time in Prussia, there was a state monopoly on coffee and tobacco, and he abolished that.
Hi, everyone. So as Rimbo, our violist, already mentioned, these quartets, the six of them, were dedicated to Frederick William II, the King of Prussia at that time. So what's really cool about these six quartets, is that Haydn, instead of giving the cello like an accompanimental part, he actually wrote a lot of soloistic lines throughout all the four movements of each quartet. And you'll hear other cellos demonstrate, but right now I'm going to demonstrate one of those passages for you guys.
Thank you. Thank you.